お待たせいたしました。こちらリンゴでございます。大変申し訳ありません。すぐに新しいものをお持ちいたします。こんにちは、ジャパニーズオモのミサです。 Hey guys, today I'm going to teach you 敬語 The respectful language. So without knowing this 敬語 You can't generally work in a Japanese company. You will hear this everywhere. The store clerks will speak in this 尊敬語 to you. Or if you are speaking to a professor or teacher, you will use this 尊敬語 as well.So in this video, we're going to mainly focus on the 尊敬語 used at restaurants. But first, let me quickly explain this 敬語. So we have three groups of 敬語. So the first one is the this must speech. It's called 丁寧語. 丁寧語. And it means polite language. 丁寧な means polite. For example, 丁寧な話し方 means the polite way of speaking. So must is used for verbs, right? For example, 日本語を勉強します。 This is a 丁寧語 polite language. So this is like the standard polite form. Or when you want to say, this is a pen. これはペンです。 That's also 丁寧語. So this is really basic. You already know this one. And the other two are the kind of more complicated ones.So the second group is called 謙譲語. It means humble language. So this is used to talk about yourself, okay, your own action, the speaker's action. So you guys know the phrase いただきます, right? This is the phrase we use before eating. It basically means I shall humbly eat this thing. いただきます basically means the same as 食べます.飲みます and even もらいます to receive. So いただきます means I humbly receive, eat, drink. And also in the sketch you saw at the beginning, I said お待たせいたしました. It means something like sorry for making you wait, thank you for waiting. This is just the phrase that we always say to somebody who probably waited for you.Like, even if they didn't wait that long, they would still say, お待たせいたしました。And this is also the 謙譲語, humble speech. So, 待たせる is the standard way to say to make someone wait. So, for example, if you're speaking to your friend, you'd say, 待たせてごめん。待たせてごめん。Or, お待たせ。お待たせ。Literally, sorry for making you wait, or thank you for waiting. And you have this お and いたします, and it makes the humble speech. So you use this humble speech when talking about yourself to someone you have to respect. For example, your teachers, your bosses, superiors, or people who are older than you, or your customers. But you also use this 謙譲語 when talking about your family,and your company. So we have this concept, uchi and soto. So uchi means inside. So basically people who are in your social circle, usually families and your company. So if somebody asks me about my family, I have to use this 謙譲語, humble speech, about my family's action. So it's still very common in Japan to have a landline.固定電話. So when I lived with my mom, somebody would call me and ask for my mom. For example, they would say, お母様はいらっしゃいますか? お母様はいらっしゃいますか? So お母様 is a very formal way to say your mother. So お母さん is used when talking about somebody's mom orYour mom informally, right? But if you're talking about your customer's mother, you have to say お母様, お母様, okay? And then お母様はいらっしゃいますか? This is in the respectful form that I'm gonna talk about in a minute. So this is a very polite way to say, is your mother there? And I could say, 母は今うちにおりません。母は今うちにおりません。So the word 母 is used to talk about your mother, the speaker's mother, formally, right? So I say 母 to mean my mother. 母は今うちに at home おりません。So おりません is the same as いません, not here, not existing here. But because I have to speak humbly about my own mother, I use this verb おりません。So if I'm just talking to my neighbors, like I don't have to really speak that formally, I could just say 母はいません. My mom is not here. But if I want to speak as formally as the listener, I would say 母はおりません. My mother is not here. So this leads to the third group, 尊敬語. 尊敬語 means respectful language.Like 敬語, but 敬語 is the name of three groups combined. But 尊敬語 specifically refers to the language that's used about someone's or the listener's action, never yours or never your family's. So for example, if you want to say, are you doing da 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 da, you have to use this 尊敬語 if you're talking to someone who you have to respect.People who are older than you, people who have more experiences than you, or the customers. So for the sentence, is your mother there? I said, お母様はいらっしゃいますか? So this, いらっしゃいますか, is the honorific word, 尊敬語. So 謙譲語, the humble language, is used when talking about the speaker's or the speaker's social circle's action. うち?Right? And this 尊敬語, the respectful or honorific language, is used about 外, outside, outsiders. So basically who's not a part of your family or a company. So this gets a bit complicated because you still have to use this 尊敬語 about your boss's action, your superior's actions. So you'd say社長がいらっしゃいます。The president is here. But if you're talking about your company, to people who are outside of your company, so maybe other companies, then you have to use the humble speech about your company, including your boss. So you say 社長はおります to mean that the president is here when talking to other companies. But if there is no outsider involvedAnd you're talking to your superiors, you have to use 尊敬語, the honorific language. It's basically because you want the other company to feel more important. And if you're using 尊敬語 about your boss, then they don't feel good enough about themselves. So it's like they want you to take their side, not your boss. So, 尊敬語 is basically used to suck up to somebody. So, 尊敬語 basically raises the position of the listener, whilst 謙譲語, the humble language, lowers your position. So, when talking about their own action, you have to be like, oh my gosh, you're doing so great. And then when you're talking about your own action, you have to be like, oh, I'm nothing. Like, you have to be super humble. So, 謙譲語 and 尊敬語 and 丁寧語 これはペンです Okay, now listen to the following dialogues set in a fast food restaurant and also another restaurant. Don't worry if you don't understand anything. I just want you to listen to the dialogues first and then I will explain the 敬語 used in these dialogues. Okay!
Fast food restaurant でいらっしゃいませ店内で召し上がりますか?
持ち帰りで。
かしこまりました。ご注文をどうぞ。
チーズバーガー一つとポテト L で。
お飲み物はいかがですか?
結構です。
かしこまりました。ご注文確認させていただきます。チーズバーガーを一つ。L サイズのポテトを一つ。ご注文は以上でよろしいでしょうか?
はい、
お会計は690円でございます。1000円お預かりいたします。310円お返しいたします。レシートでございます。こちらで少々お待ちください。ファーストフードレストランで。いらっしゃいませ、店内で召し上がりますか？持ち帰りで。かしこまりました。ご注文をどうぞ。チーズバーガー一つとポテト L で。お飲み物はいかがですか？結構です。かしこまりました。ご注文を確認させていただきます。チーズバーガーを一つ、 L サイズのポテトを一つ、ご注文は以上でよろしいでしょうか？はい、お会計は690円でございます。1000円お預かりいたします。310円お返しいたします。レシートでございます。こちらで少々お待ちください。 Next。 次、レストランで。 At the restaurant。 いらっしゃいませ、何名様でしょうか？2人です。2名様ですね。お席にご案内いたします。メニューでございます。失礼いたします、ご注文を伺います。はい、カツカレーを一つお願いします。お飲み物はいかがですか？生ビール一つ。ご注文確認させていただきます。カツカレーを一つと生ビールを一つ、以上でよろしいでしょうか？はい、お待たせいたしました、こちらカツカレーでございます。申し訳ありません、お支払いはレジでお願いいたします。お会計は3400円でございます。またのご来店お待ちしております。レストランで。いらっしゃいませ、何名様でしょうか？2人です。2名様ですね。お席にご案内いたします。メニューでございます。失礼します、ご注文を伺います。はい、カツカレーを一つお願いします。お飲み物はいかがですか？生ビール一つ。ご注文確認させていただきます。カツカレーを一つと生ビールを一つ、以上でよろしいでしょうか？はい、お待たせいたしました、こちらカツカレーでございます。申し訳ありません、お支払いはレジでお願いいたします。お会計は3400円でございます。またのご来店お待ちしております。 Again, now let's learn 敬語 through these dialogues. So first, いらっしゃいませ、いらっしゃいませ。 So if you've been to Japan, you probably have heard this phrase many times. If you go to Marukyu in Shibuya, you'll definitely hear women screeching like いらっしゃいませ、いらっしゃいませ、いらっしゃいませ。Pretty annoying, right? I know. So this is the phrase that store clerks use to welcome people. So do you remember this irashaimasu? I used it when explaining the sonkeigo
お母様はいらっしゃいますか? So, いらっしゃいませ is basically like, you're here and I respect that. Oh, oh my gosh, you're here. I'm kidding. It shows some respect to the listener, right? But いらっしゃいませ means, please come in, please come. So you use it about the customer's action. So いらっしゃいます is the same as 行きます to go, 来ます to come, and います to be somewhere, right? So as you can see, all these three verbs have this special form, いらっしゃいます, right? So some verbs have this special form. So do you remember there was a question, 店内で召し上がりますか? In the dialogue at the fast food restaurant.店内で means inside the restaurant. 店内 basically means お店の中で but nobody says お店の中で it's just too long. We say 店内で店内で召し上がりますか? So this 召し上がります means the same as 食べます to eat and 飲みます to drink. So again, remember this 尊敬語cannot be used about yourself. So when you're eating, don't use this 召し上がる, but only use this verb 召し上がる about someone eating, the listener eating. So some verbs completely change, but there aren't that many of these, so don't worry. I'll make a separate video about these special forms. For now, remember these, いらっしゃいます, 召し上がります,And also, if you can, remember, なさいます。So this is the 尊敬語 respectful language of the verb する to do, します。So instead of してください, you will hear なさってください。なさってください。Anyway, 召し上がりますか is the correct way to say will you eat?And that's showing respect. But you will hear Japanese people say, お召し上がりですか? お召し上がりですか? This is incredibly common, but grammatically wrong. Okay? So, 召し上がる is the special form that means to eat, to drink. But for other verbs that don't have special forms,You put the prefix お at the beginning and then verb in the must form stem. So if it's 書く, then 書き, like 書きます, but without must, 書き. And then you put になります. So when you want to say, will you write? And you want to show respect to that person's action, you want to say お書きになりますか? お書きになりますか?So even Japanese people find this 敬語 really difficult and you will hear a lot of people making mistakes. And because we have this お blah blah になります for 尊敬語 respectful language, we get confused like do we still have to add お to the special forms 召し上がる? So people tend to think, oh, we need to say お召し上がり? Is that correct?But in fact, it is wrong. Even if your Japanese friends say, it's fine, it's actually not. Although, because it's so common, people tend to say, nah, it's okay. But you have to know that it's wrong, okay? So you'll see these prefixes, o and go, everywhere in this 敬語. Like take out, we say, お持ち帰り, お持ち帰り.So, 持ち帰り is like the standard way to say take out. But we have to add this お about the customer's action. Because the customer is taking out, right? So you have to say your honorable take out. So I didn't use this in the dialogue, but you could, for example, say ご注文がお決まりになりましたらそちらのボタンでお呼びください。ご注文がお決まりになりましたら、 そちらのボタンでお呼びください。
So, ご注文 is your order. And お決まりになりましたら、
So, 決まる means to decide.
お、and then must them of 決まる is 決まり。
決まります。
So, 決まり。And then になりました。
なります is in the past tense. なりました。Because of the conditional form たら。So generally when you're speaking not so formally, you have to use the simple past tense, so informal past tense with the conditional form tara. But when you're speaking super super formally, you're talking to your customer, you use this mashitara, deshitara all the time.
If お決まりになりましたら
literally means if you decide.
And then お呼びください。
So this is how you request in 敬語. So you say お plus must form stem plus ください. So normally when you want to say please do something, we learn that we use the te form plus ください. Right? Like we say 待ってください to mean please wait. And this sounds formal, polite enough. But if you're talking to a customer, you have to use this super formal 尊敬語. And say,
お待ちください。お待ちください。
So this is only basically used when you're speaking to customers or your bosses. If you're speaking to, for example, senpai, you just say, 待ってください。待ってください。But yeah, if you're talking to a really important client and say, 待ってください、people might be like,You're not really good. So you want to say, お待ちください. See, 待つ is the verb to wait, right? And the must form is 待ちます. Right? 待ちます. So without must, お待ちください. So at the restaurant, you'll probably hear,
こちらにおかけになってお待ちください. こちらにおかけになってお待ちください。
こちら again is more formal way to say ここ
おかけになって。
So usually we use the verb 座る。So generally we say ここに座ってください。But there is a more formal way to say to sit, which is かける。Very formally we tend to use this verb かける instead.This is not like 尊敬語 word or anything. It's just more formal word.
かける.
So, おかけになる is a very formal and polite way to say sit down, take a seat. You can also say お座りください. That's fine too. But おかけください is more polite. So, おかけになって perform and then お待ちください.Please wait a moment. And this is nothing to do with 敬語, but you heard the customer say
持ち帰りで,
right? 持ち帰りで. So this is a very common way to order something. You say something that you want plus で. So we sometimes don't even say ください, お願いします. We just say
コーラ一つで, ハンバーガー一つで、豚骨ラーメン一つで。
It's very, very common. Okay, so that's the 尊敬語 you heard in the dialogue. And now let's talk about 謙譲語 So at the restaurant, the waitress said,
2名様ですね。お席にご案内いたします。2名様ですね。お席にご案内いたします。
So you can count two people like 二人, right? So the customer said 二人, 二人です. But the waitresses can't say 二人ですね. They have to say
二名様ですね.
Again, that's to respect the two people, okay?
二名様.
If it's one person, instead of 一人, which is the standard way to say one person, 一人, they'd say
お一人様。お一人様。
So if you come in alone, you say 一人です。They're saying
お一人様ですね。
And then here comes the humble speech.
お席に
ご案内いたします。次、お席。We put this お because it's the customer's precious seat. Right? お席 instead of just 席. If you say 席に案内します, that sounds rude. Okay? But I mean, if you're speaking to, again, your neighbor, that's fine. But if you are speaking to a customer, you have to お席に and then ご案内いたします。So for 尊敬語, you say おましてんになります。The honorific speech, you say おましてんします。おいたします。おご plus noun plus します。おいたします。So it can be either いたしますをします。But this いたします is the humble way to say します。To do. Okay? So in the first sketch, you heard すぐにお持ちいたします。This is the humble way to say 持ってきます。I will bring. 持ってきます。お持ちいたします。持ち comes from the verb 持つ。Okay? And we already did お待たせいたしました。From the verb 待たせる。Right? お今へお手伝いいたします。I will help you, or let me help you. お手伝いいたします。手伝う is the verb, and 手伝います。And without ます、お手伝いいたします。or without いた part, and say お手伝いします。Adding いたします sounds more polite, by the way. So,お手伝いします is fine, but お手伝いいたします sounds more polite. And I also say go plus noun plus します, right? So this is another hard part about 敬語. You have to know which one to put お and which one to put go. So the general rule is お is used in front of the Japanese words.Or the words that have kunyomi, the Japanese reading, and go is used in front of the onyomi sound words, the words that are borrowed from China. But there are exceptions as well, just easier to remember as you go. So basic words that have o at the beginning is like omizu, ocha.See, here is already an exception. Cha is an onyomi, Chinese reading, but we still put o. Omizu, ocha, ohana, okane, otera, oseki, ojikan. But go is used with compound nouns that have Chinese readings. Onyomi. Go chūmon, go chūi, go rikai. So,ご案内いたします。We can't say お案内 unfortunately. We say ご案内いたします。Again, いたす is from します, right? And I said that you also say ご注文, right? We use ご, not お注文. ご注文, like your order. ご注文はお決まりですか? So speaking of this, ご注文, in the dialogue you probably heard,ご注文確認させていただきます。ご注文確認させていただきます。Remember this, いただきます? I say that that's the humble way to say to receive, to eat, to drink, right? Like, いただきます。I humbly eat this thing. 確認する is to check or to make sure. And 確認させていただきます。So this させる is the causative form. Again, I have a lesson on this, but させる usually means to make somebody do something or to let somebody do something. So させていただく literally means I humbly receive the permission from you to do something. So,確認させていただきます literally means I humbly receive your permission of me checking the order. So, you know, it's a bit too much, right? So we don't use this させていただきます everywhere. But this is like a set phrase you always would hear. ご注文確認させていただきます Everywhere, so just remember it. And then in the dialogue, you also heard
失礼いたします。ご注文を伺います。
So the phrase 失礼します is used when you enter a doctor's room or a teacher's room and also when you leave the room as well.
But 失礼いたします
is more polite than just 失礼します。Remember, いたします is the humble way to say to do します。So it's like, sorry for disturbing you guys.
失礼いたします。ご注文を伺います。
So this is the special form for the verb
聞く、聞きます。
And 伺います only means to ask.
質問を伺います。
I will ask you a question humbly. Or it's more natural to ask.
質問を伺ってもよろしいですか?お、質問を伺ってもよろしいでしょうか?
May I humbly ask you a question? Okay, so 伺います is the special form of the verb
聞きます。
And another special form of the 謙譲語 that you heard in the dialogue would be
でございます。でございます。
So this でございます is used like this.And often used when you give the thing that you have to another person. So you say, レシートでございます。Here's your receipt. Or you say,
こちらカツカレーでございます。
Here's your カツカリー。So when introducing your own family to your, for example, teacher or boss, you say,
母でございます。
This is my mother.
父でございます。
This is my father. So this can turn into でございます when speaking humbly. This becomes
でいらっしゃいます
when speaking 尊敬語, the respectful language. Also, remember that when you ask a question, ですか often becomes
でしょうか?
でしょうか? I have a lesson on this, でしょう, so check it out, but you will often hear
よろしいでしょうか?よろしいでしょうか?よろしい
is a very formal way to say いい。
いい。
Good. So, よろしいでしょうか means the same as いいですか? So, it can mean is it good? Or is it okay? Is it fine? So, you hear the phrase
ご注文は以上でよろしいでしょうか?ご注文は以上でよろしいでしょうか?
That means, will that be all? So, as for the order, ご注文は以上 is like, that's all.
よろしいでしょうか?
Is that fine? Is that good? Is that okay? And just like this word, よろしい, there are a few words that are just used in 敬語. So, for example, when apologizing to a customer,
すみません is not enough.
You have to say
申し訳ありません or 申し訳ございません
申し訳 basically means the same as 言い訳 which is the standard way to say an excuse but
申し訳ございません or ありません
literally means I do not have an excuse so I do not have an excuse for thisPlease accept my apology.
申し訳ありません or ございません
is more formal. You have to remember, ございます is the humble way to say あります. Like, でございます means the same as です. But ございます on its own means the same as ある, but more humble. And ございません, that's negated, so there is no, I don't have. So,
申し訳ございません。
And then you can also add the word 大変 which means like terribly. So 大変申し訳ございません I'm terribly sorry. Okay, phew, that's all for today. There are a lot more forms, unfortunately, but I don't want to overwhelm you in this video alone. So I'm gonna make more videos about 敬語 But this time I want you to focus on the 敬語 that you hear at the restaurant specifically. So now that you know some of the 敬語, listen to the same dialogues again and I hope you understand a little bit more. But honestly, even if you're not going to work at the Japanese restaurant, it's really nice to be able to recognize the forms, like the forms that they're using, or you can be nitpicking the mistakes that they'd be making and have fun secretly. Never tell them though, because they would be offended. Anyway, I hope you've learned a lot from this lesson. I know it is really difficult, and as I told you, Japanese people make mistakes all the time when speaking this 敬語. So don't worry, take it easy. You will get it. Alright, so enjoy the dialogues again.
ファーストフードレストランで。いらっしゃいませ。店内で召し上がりますか？
持ち帰りで。
かしこまりました。ご注文をどうぞ。
チーズバーガー一つとポテト L で。
お飲み物はいかがですか？
結構です。
かしこまりました。ご注文確認させていただきます。チーズバーガーを一つ、L サイズのポテトを一つ。ご注文は以上でよろしいでしょうか？
はい、お会計は690円でございます。
1000円お預かりいたします。
310円お返しいたします。
レシートでございます。こちらで少々お待ちください。
次、レストランで。
At the restaurant。いらっしゃいませ。何名様でしょうか？
2人です。
2名様ですね。お席にご案内いたします。
メニューでございます。
失礼いたします。
ご注文を伺います。
はい、
カツカレーを一つお願いします。
お飲み物はいかがですか？
生ビール一つ。
ご注文確認させていただきます。カツカレーを一つと生ビールを一つ。以上でよろしいでしょうか？
はい。
お待たせいたしました。こちらカツカレーでございます。
申し訳ありません。
お支払いはレジでお願いいたします。お会計は3400円でございます。またのご来店お待ちしております。
Okay, how did it go? Okay, so thank you so much for watching the video. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and share it with everybody. And if you want more videos like this, please let me know in the comments. And if you could support me on Patreon, I would really appreciate it. Thank you so much!
ありがとうございます。
じゃあまたね。バイバーイ。